What's up, Lashanistas? Welcome to the show. This is the Live Bay Podcast, where we talk about the ever-growing eyelash business. If this is your first time listening to our show, welcome. This podcast is dedicated to helping you grow as a lash artist and or lash business owner. So whether you work for yourself or someone else, this podcast is for you.
Hey guys, this is Mike and Shauna Jones. We are the owners of Live Bay Lash. Our heart is to share with you our uphill battle in this lash industry and to show you what started out of a tiny bedroom in our house, extremely broke, has turned into an eight-figure company. We are here to encourage you during your lash journey and to give you guys a real raw version of what things really like.
Yeah, in today's episode, we're going to be talking about marketing. Some of you guys right now are having a hard time getting clients or selling products right now. And that's because of there's some issues going on. We're going to kind of jump into and give you some practical stuff to help you. Before we jump into that, though, we do have some upcoming classes. So we're going to be in Las Vegas. We're not going anywhere for that one. September 27th, we're going to be in Newark, New Jersey. October 11th, we're going to be in Cleveland, Ohio. October 18th. Guys, listen, please, let's get signups for Cleveland. Sean and I will be there if we get enough signups. Give us an excuse to come visit my family, say hi to you guys, go to a Browns game, do all in one.
Yeah.
With emphasis on the Browns game. Just putting it out there.
So fun. We can't wait to watch them lose.
Wow. Wow. Sorry, Cleveland.
Kidding.
I love you.
That's just kidding. They'll be good this year.
She's not from there. We forgive her. We're going to be in Scottsdale, October 25th, Portland, November 1st. And you can check it out at Las Vegas, or I'm sorry, Live Bay Classes.
Las Vegas. LasVegas.com.
You can check it out at Vegas.com. You also get tickets for your shows. tell them about the online membership real quick.
Yes, online membership, $99 a month. You have access to Mike and I. You get one free live per month, four free tutorials per month, 20% off products, a free gift per month.
Whoa. I mean, the list just goes on and on. There's so much value there.
Yeah, so it's great for, you know, mentoring or any questions you have. If you took a one-day class and your lash trainer ignores you, then sign up with us.
Yes. Also, we opened our location in Old Town Scottsdale. It's right on East 5th Avenue, right behind Fashion Square Mall.
Yes.
If you're in that area and need supplies, it's got a full retail area. Plus, it's open now for services. Beautiful location.
So cute.
Even if you are just in the area, make sure you pop in, say hi, check it out.
Yeah.
All right. So jumping the episode. So we get this question a lot lately. People are coming to us and are saying, hey, I don't know what's going on. I'm trying to sell products, or I'm trying to do classes, or I'm trying to get clients into my salon so I can do lashes. And I'm running ads and I'm just having not much success lately. You know what I mean? On my paid media. And so this is something we're dealing with right now. So we used to spend about $170,000 a month on ads between Facebook, Google, Instagram, some Snapchat
per
ads.
Per month.
Per month. $170,000 per month. And that would drive in about $1.7 million or more, $1.8 million a month in gross sales. That would be between classes, products, and our salons. Fast forward, in April, at the very end of April, Apple came out with an update that no longer lets people be tracked. I mean, this might be sound like I'm speaking Russian here, but all of you guys have downloaded an app, and when you get the app downloaded, one of the first thing it asks you is, would you like to be tracked? And people are like, oh, no, and they hit no right away, and they opt out, right? What this has done is you can no longer track people's like 7 and 10 day buying tendencies. So I'll give you an example. Let's say Shauna is a sneakerhead and she loves Air Jordans. And I'm studying like the stuff she's clicking on. I know she loves sneakers. I know what type of sneakers. It's not just Vans, even though she likes Vans better. Mm-hmm. Let's just say it's Jordans. I can actually see when she's purchasing, what type of sneakers she's purchasing. And I now know how to track. And when I go to advertise, I can build what's called a lookalike audience, where I can find people that are similar to Shauna, same age, demographic, same buying tendencies, similar likes, and I can now network and market to them. So because of the tracking being gone now, it's become very difficult to, you know, basically build those lookalikes and go after a broader audience now. And so the current clients you have now, you're going to have to really, really work hard to keep them happy and keep them in. You don't want to be losing them. What happened was, after Apple came up with that update and screwed everybody, and I've talked to friends of mine that have like huge e-commerce businesses or have other brick and mortar companies, and they're saying like they're getting clobbered. Like they used to spend all this money on ads. You know what I mean? I told you we went from spending $170 a month to now $295,000 a month.
Ooh.
And we're getting a couple hundred thousand less in sales per month now. Mm-hmm. So then what Google and Facebook did, they got together and said, well, not only can they not track people anymore, but we're going to increase the cost of freight. We're going to make the ad spend go up. So they published a statistic the other day. It said the cost of ads have gone up 800%. So if you used to run a shoestring budget on Facebook every day at $5 a day for 2,000 people, that's now $15 a day to try and hit those same people. And you're just kind of recklessly throwing stuff against the wall and hoping to get, you're hoping for clicks now more than you are actually being able to kind of target, retarget, hit them with different, you know what I mean, and bring them into your world. So it's become a lot more difficult now to track people and to kind of find out like where those sources are coming from. Even if you have like a really good API in place, it's become difficult now to track people. They've gotten away rid of like pixel tracking, all that stuff. So we're going to give you guys kind of some practical tips now on what to do to kind of get people in the door, because I think that this is the new norm. Just like you hear people talking about COVID, this is the new norm. This is the new norm for advertising now. And I know lots of people that are struggling with this right now.
That was really good.
I thought you were going to chip in there.
I am going to chip in.
Okay,
no.
Okay.
I was just telling you. I was giving you a compliment.
And that's all we got for you today.
I was giving you a compliment.
Thank you. Oh,
that's so nice.
Bam.
Anyways, I was going to say it's really important that you guys are, you know, collecting a lot of data. So if you didn't before with like emails, phone numbers, all that stuff, like I was telling Tori who does our emails, like, hey, let's, you know, get our organic reach going.
We should talk about Tori. It's not like she's here.
Yeah. No, she does a good job. But anyways, like sending out more emails per week, really annoying the fuck out of our customers. I'm just kidding. Hey, we're desperate. Please buy from us. No, I'm just kidding. But really hitting that like organic reach. Cause you know, we do have so much information in our databases. So just getting more creative with like our own marketing. You know, I did bitch out our marketing guy, Renee. I'm like, what are you doing? Like before I really understood like what was going on. I told him to basically get off Call of Duty. Cause that's all he does all day. No, I'm just kidding. He kind of does, but in his panties. No, I'm just kidding. So now I understand, you know, especially talking to like Mike was talking to Ramon. He's like super high up, like has an e-commerce. He's like, dude, it's killing us too. And then I noticed like, you know, for the past few months, all of the lash companies have been doing killer sales. I'm like, everybody's doing killer sales like every
week. People
doing
like 50% off sales weekly. It's some of the big brands out there.
I'm like, what's
going on? They don't
even
do that for Black Friday.
Yeah. So that's why I was like, okay, I guess as an owner, I should probably read up into this and like figure out what's going on. So it is legit. But I told, you know, our marketing guy, I'm like, we got to get creative with this. Like we always have to be prepared to when shit hits the fan like this, like we have other avenues to kind of like come together and figure out like ideas, get creative. So I think, you know, staying on top of like your postings per day, you know, obviously post when there's, you know, more interaction going on. Always make sure that you have someone on your social media, if it isn't you, to comment back, to like things, tons of engagement. Get creative with your photos and videos. Angelina posted, like, we did this super cute thing that Gabby found on TikTok of like an image with like water and our products and stuff like that. Super cute. Just get creative. Like now's the time you really have to knuckle down and think outside the box just to keep your stuff going, because obviously we're spending more and we're bringing in less. So, you know, you want to.
Yeah.
So got to find a workaround.
Let's break it down in three practical tips. And I'm not telling you guys to abandon paid media, because certainly we're not either. Just know you're going to have to spend a lot more than you used to. Even now, Renee gives me a report every month, and I know which of my competitors have ran out of budget for the month.
Yeah.
Because they'll be going heavy paid, heavy paid, heavy paid, and by the fourth week of the month, they're no longer doing any paid, and they're just doing 50% off
sales.
They're
on OnlyFans. I'm just kidding.
They're dropping their pants.
They're selling feet pics. That might be me if we keep this up.
Used to be stripper, but didn't put on weight.
Mike's feet are on OnlyFans.
Oh, God. I don't even want to see my feet.
All right, go.
Anyway, here's some practical tips. You're still going to spend your paid media, but listen, here's three things. Number one, I want to go back to what she just said. If you're not using a good booking system, like a Booker, a Vagaro, MindBody, any of those types of systems, you need to get one. And a good one you're going to have to pay for per month. And it could be something cheap, like $99 a month. But here's why you need it. It does have the ability to track their name, address, phone number. You can put their birthday in there. It's got notes sections, so you can write down things about them. Why that's important, because if you keep a good, and we have to stay on our receptionists too. Like our receptionists at our front desk are like, hey, how you doing? And it's like, did you get their name? Yeah, I put their first name in. What about their phone number? No, do I need that? What about their email? It's like, what are you doing? I need that information. You want as much detail as possible. I'm not talking about annoying them. You don't need their Zodiac sign. You don't need all that crap. But here's the thing. A good database will track all that stuff, so you can get a MailChimp subscription and email blast your customers. We went to a summit a couple years ago, and there was a supplement company there that was doing like $600 million a year in revenues, and they didn't do any paid media. All they did was email blast. And what they would do is they would put up free tips online. It would be like, summer trends to get the six pack the quickest way. Get shredded now. Want to know? Opt in. And people put their email address in, and it would be an article they had written, like a blog, talking about like summertime tips on how to lose weight. Anyways, because they opted in, they then had their email address and their permission to email blast them, and they kept refining that list. And so you can email people, and what happens is, if they get to a point where they become emotionally disconnected, meaning they're no longer opening that email, and you can see it's been 60, 90 days, you need to keep refining your list. Pull those dead weight ones out of there that are no longer opening it. They're just hitting spam boxes. Keep the fresh ones always going, doing little things, little promos, talking about your business, little discount codes, little things. And that's free because they're already in your organic database. That's why it's important to get a good booking system to track that info. The other reason you want to have a good booking system is it allows you to keep those notes. So when they come back in, you know little details about their life. And you ever want to get like the key to a woman's heart? Everybody used to say it's a diamond ring or it's food. No, talk about their kids. You remember little details about their kids? You ever do anything about, you ever bring up Olive and Baylor by name and do anything nice for my kids? You'd be my wife's new best friend. Mm-hmm. And it's the truth. It used to be me, but now it's the kids. That's just, yeah. Kidding.
It happens that way.
But that's the thing. Those little notes are the difference between making that client be your client for life because they read, they see that you truly care, and just being some schmuck who's trying to club them over the head and make a quick buck. Number two, we talked about this before, not with the paid media, but what she was saying with the content, putting out the constant videos, doing TikTok videos, doing Instagram reels, doing YouTube videos, you need to be thinking outside the box, content, content, content. If you take a piece of content and you make a short on TikTok and an Instagram reel with it, then put it on YouTube, make a short reel, you know what I mean? You're hitting three different channels, three different avenues. That's an organic reach, okay? That's not a paid ad. You're putting out constant contact, engaging people. People are finding you on different avenues, right? And sometimes people are like, oh, TikTok's dumb. I get it. You know, my wife loves TikTok. I think some of the videos are so funny. Cool. But that's a great avenue because it's right now it's so new and like on its way up the door. Anybody who's getting in right now ground level and putting out those kind of videos, you're going to be at the forefront of that thing. You know what I mean? And then the other thing is, like, don't give away free tips of the day. Do YouTube videos on free tips. These are all like practical little things, and it's organic. You need to be putting out constant info every day. Think to yourself, I'm going to put out 5 or 10 photos and videos every day on different channels. That's free, okay? And then the third thing we're going to talk about that I think's, again, a lost art is the just following people. You're going to hear me say this forever until I'm blue in the face. But you could sit there, like we went into Scottsdale, brand new area where we have no following whatsoever, right? I mean, people know who we are for products, but not necessarily for a salon. We went into that area and we're spending all this money on marketing. We did some SEO stuff, but there's nothing coming quicker than her actually following all of our competitors' followers and following the ASU girls. That's working 6 times more, but people don't want to do it because they don't want to spend the time. And I can't stress this enough. Go into it one more time. For the 3,000th time, explain about following people.
Yes, so following people.
Try
I did
to be
it this
excited.
Morning. So, so following people. So I went to like all of the main like bars and like little nightclubs, day clubs in Scottsdale, which I wasn't even familiar with. And then I would just follow like all of the girls, and I would follow all of their followers. And then you kind of realize that like you've kind of hit your mark when you go through someone's followers. You're like, oh shit, I'm already following all of them. So all the ASU girls, we have a promo running too for like ASU girls right now, $25 off full sets and fills. And then yeah, just following people. Before I used to like their photos, but now I'll comment on them. So, you know, maybe if they're just like ignoring me when I like their photos, they'll be like, oh, this person's like commenting, like what's going on? They go to our page, they see all of our amazing lash pictures. Oh, hey, they're running a promo, and then they book with us. So I think that's really important right now with marketing just kind of going the way it is. I did want to say too about like the booking system, like the amazing thing about the booking system is like we'll always pull reports like every 3 months, 6 months, and we'll see like who has spent the most money with us, like with for supplies, for services, and we'll put together like a really cute basket. I think that's important
nice
because nowadays, like no one spends the time to like actually get gifts. It's always gift cards or like whatever. But there's a lot of thought that goes into like a really cute basket. Like I love that stuff. So if anybody wants to send me a basket. I would love that. If it had Starbucks in it, like iced coffees in it, I would just die. But nobody takes the time to like actually go and like shop for something. Like there's a cute cafe here, Cafe Lola, for Christmas. I actually went to Ross and I like got stuff for like this cute basket. I put like candles in it and like all this stuff and it matched and I had cute tissue paper and I dropped it off and they never said thank you, which that sucked. But it was fun while I did it. But stuff like that, like for your customers, like actually going, gathering things and putting stuff together. We do that for like our high spenders, for people who maybe hate us now that don't buy supplies. And we're like, hey, we noticed you haven't shopped with us in like a year. You know, I sent out like an email that's like, hey, I miss you. And they're probably like, oh, screw you. I hate Live Bay. But I gave them a 20% off coupon. So in case they want to give me a try again, even though they may hate me, 20% off. I mean, come on. And if they ignore that, then I keep going and going until I get their business. So that's an amazing thing about a booking system and what it allows you to do to kind of like attract people back into your world.
Yeah. And these are like three just super very practical, like we didn't come in like, all right, we're going to show you how to dissect things and track. And like, this is very easy, very practical three tips to do. And I think it's a lost art. And here's the thing. I would love to just keep running paid media and running paid media and running, you know what I mean? But at some point in time, paid media has like its reach, you know what I mean? So that's why, you know, it's like you look at a pie, it's like a 50-50 thing. 50% still going to be your paid media, you know, hitting the low hanging fruit. And the other 50% is just going to be like that organic reach, doing stuff to retarget and hit your already current following that you have. And that's why it's super important to do those things. And I promise you, even with the cost of ads going up and making it harder to track people now, if you follow these tips, very, very practical things, your business are going to be just fine.
Yeah.
Well, that's all we got for you guys today. Hopefully you got some great value from this. As always, if you haven't done so yet, please subscribe to the podcast, subscribe to our YouTube channel. Make sure to join our support Facebook group, The Last
T-E-A.
And until then, we'll see you in the next episode.
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you.